Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. My name is Katariina. Today's video is the second update for my Pantat palette for 2021. This year I do have three different Pantat palettes. The Modern Renaissance from Anastasia Beverly Hills was my Pantat palette last year and I wanted to keep working on it still at least for another 6 months. Then I do have two other Pantat palettes for the first half of the year. My main Pantat palette will be the BH Cosmetics Modern Matte Eyeshadow Palette, and for the second half of the year my main Pantat palette will be the Too Faced Chocolate Bar Eyeshadow Palette. However, I do still want to work on both of these palettes throughout the entire year, even though right now I'm not that focused on Chocolate Bar, I'm only focusing on a couple of shades. This time my progress is not quite as good as it was in January. However, I have still been able to make some progress and I do have some changed goals that I wanted to share with you. So let's just get into my progress. Let's start with the Chocolate Bar palette, because with this one my progress is clearly the worst, if you can say so. I don't expect to make good progress with this palette at all yet, but there are some shades that I do want to focus on already, and that's why I do want to include it into my Pantat palette update videos. So let me show you where I was with this palette a month ago. And this is what the palette is looking like right now. So as you can see, there's not big changes. So yeah, what comes to this palette, there are two shades that I have been focusing on. So first one of them being Triple Fudge. That is something that I do wear on my brows. I do have it on my brows today. And also Candid Violet I have wanted to focus on because it's my least favorite shade from the palette. And I do find it's quite a wintery shade. So because of that, I have wanted to put a little bit more effort to it. That being said, I didn't do too good with this shade during the past month. I only wore it once as a nail polish topper and once as a lower lash line color, so I totally could have done better. However, Triple Fudge I used a total 18 times on my brows, so I'm pretty happy with that and I can totally see a deep forming in this shade. I don't think I'm going to hit pan quite yet during the next month, but I will keep working on it and I think it will probably take a couple of months and then I will be able to hit pan on this. Other than that, I haven't been using this palette too much. I only created one look using only this palette. It was in the Full Face with my oldest makeup video. So in that video I created a look using this palette and I used white chocolate, black forest truffle, salted caramel, marzipan, semi-sweet amaretto and cherry cordial. So all of those shades I have used once during the past month and the other shades I didn't use at all. So yeah, as you can see, not that good progress with this palette yet. However, as I said, I don't expect to make too good progress with this yet. However, this is a difficult formula to hit pan on, so because of that I do want to kind of work on it already. So for March, I will still be wearing Triple Fudge on my brows. I don't think I can quite hit pan yet, but I do think I can get quite close. And then I still do want to focus on Candid Violet. I think after March, I do want to take a break, but during next month, I really want to do better with it than during the past month. I think I maybe should set a usage goal to this shade, so I think I will do that. I will set a usage goal of 10 uses for this shade. I know it's quite a bit, but I can also wear this as a nail polish topper. And also sometimes if I do a really basic neutral eyeshadow look, this is kind of like a fun pop of color to use as a liner. So yeah, I will set a usage goal that I want to use this for 10 times during the next month, and then I'm probably going to take a break of that shade. But yeah, that is where I am with the Chocolate Bar palette. Not too good progress with it yet. However, I'm happy to be working on it already. Okay, so let's move on to the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance eyeshadow palette. I will show you a picture where I was a month ago. And this is what the palette is looking like right now. So as you can see, I have already finished most of the shades and the shades left I have already hit pan on. This time I was able to make pretty good progress with Antique Bronze. I used it total 4 times. And every time I use it, I do use quite a bit. I do usually put it both to my crease and to the outer part of my lid. Then Venetian Red is another shade that I was able to make quite good progress. So that I used total 9 times, and that was a focus shade for me for February, and it is a shade I'm wearing today both on my crease and on the outer part of my lid. Rose Sienna and Red Ochre I used once during the past month, and then Real Garb I didn't use at all. This palette I have been panning now for a little bit over a year, and I have been going back and forth if I want to finish it or if I want to quit panning it. I feel at some point last year I felt really sick of panning it, but I have kinda got my motivation to finish this back. Since I have come such a far way, I think it would be kinda like giving up if I decided not to finish it. That being said, I do think this is the last palette that I will try to finish, because it is a commitment and I do have quite a bit of palettes. I do have, I'm not exactly sure, 16 palettes maybe at the moment. So it's not like I have a huge collection, but when I am so focused on panning just one palette, it is time away from using the other palettes. So because of that, at least I feel maybe after this year I will need a break from that palette. But since I have came this far, I feel quitting, it wouldn't make me happy. I want to see this palette finished completely. When I look at this palette, I do think it's completely realistic to do this year. The shade that is worrying me the most is Venetian Red, especially since I tried to use it as a nail polish topper, actually with the nail polish I'm wearing today, so it is like a berry color nail polish from Catrice that is in my project polish, and it is in tone really similar to Venetian Red. However, Venetian Red didn't really look like anything as a nail polish topper, so I don't think I'm going to do it again. I feel, yes, I could get good use out of the shade if I used it like that, but it would almost be like wasting the product because it really doesn't make that much of a difference to my nail polish. When I use Candied Violet from the Chocolate Pearl palette as a nail polish topper, it really gives this beautiful shimmer to my nail polish, but this one just, I don't know, maybe it gives a slightest sheen, but in my opinion, it doesn't make my nail polish look any better than it looks without using this. So I don't think I will try that again. Also, I know some of you have suggested that I could use this as a blush, but I'm just not someone who is really into bright blushes, and this is a really, really pigmented shade, and for my skin tone, I feel it would be way too difficult to blend out. So the only chance for me to finish it, I think, is to use it as an eyeshadow. So today I'm wearing this like really pink toned look, and I will say this type of looks I don't really like that often. Like, I could see myself maybe wearing a look as pink as this one maximum once a week for the rest of this year. And we only do have a little bit over 40 weeks left of this year. And if I only used this shade once a week, I don't think that 40 or a little bit over uses is enough to finish this shade. So I need to find a way to sneak this shade into some neutral looks. So maybe create a neutral look with a little bit of pink in the crease, or maybe put it into my lower lash line. I don't know, but I need to find some creative ways to incorporate into my eyeshadow looks. So if you do have any ideas of that, I would really love to hear your suggestions, how I could get good use out of it. So yeah, Venetian Red is the shade that worries me the most in this palette, but I think other than that, it's totally a realistic goal for me to finish this. There is quite a bit of product in Red Ochre, like I have just hit a small pan there. However, even though it says Red Ochre and even though it looks quite red in the pan, in reality it is just like a warm reddish brown that I think is a really wearable shade to any warm neutral eyeshadow look. So I bet I can get good use out of it. in summer and fall. Also Real Girl, there is quite a bit of product left, but I also think I could easily wear Real Girl and Red Ochre in same looks. But yeah, those three shades I would say are the more challenging ones from this palette. However, right now I feel I am ready for that challenge. I want to finish this palette, I really do. Maybe after that it will be a break from Panda palette for at least a year or a two, but now that I have already finished 9 shades out of the palette and some shades were a challenge, like Buon Fresco or Love Letter, I don't want to quit. For March, I do have one major goal for my eyeshadow panning projects, and that is to finish Antique Bronze. My goal for February was to finish the product I had left in the upper left corner, and as you can see, I wasn't quite able to do that. However, I feel I am now close enough that if I wear this shade a couple of times a week, I should be able to finish it in a month. So if I finish Antique Bronze during the next month, I am really happy. That is where I am with this palette right now. I do want to finish it. It will probably take the entire year, but I feel really motivated again to really just complete this palette. Okay, next let's talk about the ABH Cosmetics Modern Matte Eyeshadow Palette. That is my main Pantat palette for the first half of the year. I do think that now things are going to change a little bit since my main goal for this year is to get this palette finished. However, I will still be really focused on this palette until the end of June. But I do have a little bit different goals from now on what comes to this palette. But before we get to that, let's take a look into the progress I was able to make in February. So let me show you where I was last month with this palette. And this is where I am right now. So as you can see, I was able to hit one new pan. It is on this shade. I hope the camera picks it up. It is just a baby pan. I actually hit it yesterday. So yeah, that is what the palette is looking like right now. Let's go through the uses. I'm going to just talk about the shades I have used so that the video is a little bit shorter. These updates tend to now be a little bit longer because I do have 3 palettes to talk about. The white one I have used 12 times. It is something I have still been using to set my eyeshadow primer if I have wanted to set it and whenever I have gone for neutral looks. And sometimes I have used it as a brow bone highlight. And the next shade I have used is the 4th one, which is like a medium brown. This one has a little bit of red undertone to it compared to this another one that looks really similar. But in reality on eyes they are pretty much the same thing. But this one I did use 4 times during the past month. The 5th shade I used once. The 6th shade I actually used 8 times. And this is something I have been wearing on my brows. So as I said, I do wear the shade Triple Fudge from my Chocolate Bar palette. But that is a really deep shade for me. It probably is too deep. But I am determined to hit pan on it. And if it helps me to hit pan, if I wear it on my brows, I'm just going to wear it on my brows, even if it is too dark. But this is what I have been wearing more towards the inner part of my brows and the Triple Fudge one on the outer part of my brows. Then next shade that I have used during the past month is the 8th shade over here. That one I used twice. Then the 13th shade, so the beige that is almost gone at this point, I have used 5 times during the past month. The 15th shade, that is like a deep plum, I have used 8 times. This I am wearing today to deepen out the look a little bit. This one was a focus shade for me this month, as well as I think the 4 last shades from this row. However, the shade in the middle, so the shade number 18, I only wore once, so not that good. But the other shades I have been wearing, and I'm wearing all of these shades today too. So the kind of like hot pink shade, shade number 19, I wore 5 times. The little bit brighter baby pink, I wore 7 times. And this lighter baby pink, I wore 10 times. This shade is something that I have been setting my eyeshadow primer with when I have gone for pink looks. And also when I have gone for pink looks, I have worn it as a brow bone highlight. And then the another shade is something I have sometimes used as my first transition shade and also to blend things out. Then what comes to the bottom row, the only shade I have used is the black that I have been using as liner today. However, I wanted to create my line with a liquid liner, so I'm not wearing this. But 14 times I used it, I do think it's pretty good. Something you may notice that is now different with this palette is that I have taken those light green dots off this palette. They were nail polish marking from 2019 when I was doing my Shop My Shadows, where I rotated through my entire eyeshadow collection. So I took those off and now I do have new dots going on next to some of the shades. So the blue dots are shades that I do want to finish this year. And then I do want to debut this palette after this year, or perhaps even midway through the year. We'll see where I am then. But at least by the end of the year I do want to debut this, because as you can see, the packaging is broken and I don't really like all of the shades in this palette. So if there is a green dot next to a shade, that means that I do want to keep the eyeshadow. A shade where there is the green dot, of course, my favorite shade from the palette, the lime green, one of my favorite colorful eyeshadows in my entire collection. But also I did put the green dot next to the hot pink sort of matte shade. This is actually what I am wearing today in my crease. I did put this on before Love Letter. This one is clearly brighter than Love Letter and it is a nice shade. I don't go for these pink looks too often, but it is quite a unique shade to my collection and I like it, so I want to keep it. However, if you can see a red dot next to the pan, that means that I don't want to keep that shade. So in January, I was really focused on the grey eyeshadow. I just don't like this. I don't think that this is that great of a grey. And anyways, grey is not a favorite eyeshadow of mine to wear on my eyes. And even if I want to go for a grey matte eyeshadow, I do have one that is way better in my Naked Smoky palette from Urban Decay that I will never get rid of. So there is enough grey eyeshadow for me for the rest of my life. So I don't need to keep this. But then this month I decided that these two pinks, even though I have been wearing them a lot during the past month, I don't want to keep them. In the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, there is the shade Strawberry Bonbon over here. I have had this palette for over 5 years, over 5.5 years at this point, and there is a little dent going on in the shade, but I have not even hit pan on this shade. I just don't wear shades like this too often, and there is enough of matte baby pink in this shade for me for the next decade. So yeah, those are the shades I have so far made my mind about what I want to do with them after I'm done panning this palette. And I did set in the intro my goal to be to hit pan on all of these shades, but I have now realized that I don't want to kind of like reach that goal anymore or try to reach that goal, because there are a lot of colorful eyeshadows in this palette, and although I do like to wear a colorful eyeshadow once in a while, I do know myself that if I force myself to pan colorful eyeshadow, I will start hating it so much that I will never again want to reach for that kind of color again. Or at least I want to wait like 2 years until I wear it again. So yeah, because of that, I just don't want to, for example, force myself to hit pan on these turquoise shades on the bottom row. Like, these are something I might wear a couple of times a summer and that's it. My new goal when it comes to this palette is just to figure out what I want to do with the shades. Do I want to keep them? Do I want to declutter them after I debut this? And I will still want to try to finish those shades I have marked with blue. So the white, the skin color, the beige over here, and then the black. The black, I'm not sure if I can finish. We'll see. In March, as I said, my main goal when it comes to my panned palettes will be to finish Antique Bronze from Modern Renaissance. And because of that, I'm not going to set any too difficult goals when it comes to this palette. I'm not even trying to hit new pans. But there are three shades that I kind of want to make my mind about and see if I would want to keep them after depotting this palette or not. So the first one is this plum over here. I have used it quite a bit actually during the past month, but I still don't know. This is not the best quality, it's not the most pigmented plum ever. However, I do want to kind of compare it to my singles and also my eyeshadow palettes and figure out if it's something that would really bring value to me after depotting this palette. So yeah, I want to decide that. And also the blues. I know they are not necessarily the best quality blues ever, but they are rather unique to my collection. So I want to create at least a couple of different looks using these shades, and I want to decide if they are something I want to keep. So yeah, probably there's not going to be too much other progress what comes to this palette. Maybe I will be able to make some progress on this white, but I don't think I will be able to finish it by the next update. That is really everything for today. Let me know if you are doing Panda palette. I would love to check out your videos if you are doing videos about it. Panda palette is my favorite project pan ever. Thank you so much for watching this video and see you on my next one. Bye bye.